My best investment decision ever. Today we're going to discuss my best investment decision ever. This is a lot more fun talking about this today than what we talked about yesterday when we talked about my worst investment decision ever, okay? I'm actually going to give you my three best investment decisions I've ever made in my life, guys. I hope this will help you and you'll be able to see some trends maybe on future stocks and you kind of say, okay, well, Jeremy saw such and such with this stock. Maybe I can see a trend with this one, guys, which trend spotting along with the fundamentals is a lot of what goes into stock market investment. By the way, if you're a beginner in the stock market, make sure you check out that second link in the description. That's an 11-part stock market investing mastery course that goes into exactly how I invest in stocks. If you're an advanced investor, click on that first link. You got to join that group. You will get so much value out of it. It's insane, guys. So right off the bat, you would think Wynn Resorts. That's got to be up there, right? W-Y-N. And Wynn Resorts, I've talked about it so much in this channel, we're up over 130% on it, doing phenomenal. Nope, it's sure as heck not top three, it's not even top five. It would be the top 10, it would be in the top 10, but it's not even in the top five greatest investments I've ever made in my life, guys. It's just the best investment we've made since we had this channel, which the channel started last year in 2016, so it's not a very long amount of time. So Wynn's just the best in that amount of time, but it's not even top five, guys. So, coming in at number three, my third best investment decision, in my opinion, I've ever made, is a company named Trinity Industries. Ticker symbol, I believe, was TRN. Okay, this was a rail car company. They also had some construction products and whatnot, right? So, this was such a big stock for me, not just because I made a huge percentage of my money on it, not just because I made a lot of money on it. As a matter of fact, I don't even think this one would constitute as a top five biggest money maker for me. This one was so key because it gave me so much more confidence when investing in the stock market, okay? So going into stock market investing, when I started looking in the markets in 2008, I started really funneling real money in there in 2009, right? So, I've been in the game for almost a decade come next year, right? And, you know, going in, I didn't know I was going to be special in the stock market. I didn't know I was going to be a good investor. I didn't know I was going to be a great investor. I didn't know any of this. I thought maybe I can just get an average return, 8% a year. Okay, because you can't go into something new and think you're going to be the it, right? You can't think you're just going to be dominant. Otherwise, you're just kind of delusional in your own mind, right? I remember I thought I was going to be an NFL player before I ever stepped on an NFL, even a football field. And then I found I would have trouble even getting playing time in a high school football field. Never mind NFL, right? And that dream never came true. So when I go into anything nowadays, I, you know, basically after high school, I would just treat it as maybe I can be good at this, maybe I'm not. Trinity Industries allowed me to open up my mind and know I'm special at stock market investing. It was my first gains I had that were in the hundreds of percent, okay? I saw a trend coming that no one else saw coming, and I was mind blowing that no one else saw this. Fracking started really blowing up in 2008, 2009, into 2010. Fracking was a whole new industry, basically, in the United States, a way of drilling out gas and oil and all these type of things. And all that stuff has to be transported somehow. So everybody was thinking about the plays on, you know, playing like a Chesapeake Energy or different energy companies, direct plays. And I was like, well, I got an indirect play that's going to be a huge beneficiary here. So I was thinking, how's this stuff going to be transported all around the United States? And the best place I found was rail cars, which was one of Trinity Industries' biggest businesses. So all these oil and gas companies and all these drillers and whatnot, they needed to start ordering tons of rail cars to transport the oil and the gas around. No one saw this trend coming. The stock was way down and whatnot. I started buying in, and over the next couple years, between like 2010 and 2012, I think I sold out 2012, maybe 2013, it was probably 2012 though, the stock went up ridiculous rates, guys. The stock went up massively, massively. And it was the first time I really got confidence in myself with stock market investing that I knew I wasn't just an average Joe investor, that I have something here more because I can trend spot, I can look at business fundamentals and see a trend coming that other people just never see. They just never see it, guys. So that stock was huge for me from a confidence standpoint. to really know I had something special here. And, you know, like I said, it's like anything in life. You go into it. When I started this YouTube channel, man, I went into it and it was like, is it going to be special? I don't know. Maybe. It would be cool if I had 1,000 subscribers someday. And now, you know, a little over a year and a half later, we got 80,000 subscribers. It's like, you never know what's going to happen when you go into something, right? My second best investment ever was Cruise, Cirrus Logic, a stock you guys are probably familiar with. I believe that one is now on the 4 stocks I'm buying, right? Cirrus Logic. So this one I had been involved with for a little while, then I sold out, didn't make any money on it. Then came 2014, I believe it was around August or September 2014. This stock was like a $16 stock. It was like a joke. I'm like, how is this stock trading down here, right? And once again, I saw a trend that no one else could see. It was like, why is no one else seeing this trend? By the way, Cirrus Logic had a huge short position as far as like, there were so many short sellers in Cirrus Logic at that time, so much negativity. Oh, Apple might drop them or something, just delusional type stuff, right? So what I saw with Cirrus Logic is, one, I saw iPhone 6 coming, okay, which I knew was going to be a monumental iPhone. I knew it was going to be the biggest ever as far as, it was the biggest change Apple could make at the iPhone 6, because basically a lot of people had been switching to Samsung or getting Samsung phones at that time because Samsung phones had the bigger phones. They had bigger screens and all those type of things. Apple up until that time and the 5S and whatnot were 4-inch screens, so they were super small. So I knew that Apple was going to launch the bigger smartphones. And sure enough, they did. And I knew that was going to be huge. And sure enough, Apple sales exploded that year for iPhone, which Cirrus Logic is a direct beneficiary of that, because the more Apple smartphones they sell, the more Cirrus Logic revenue comes in the door, right? And then I knew the following year that more than likely Apple is going to start using what's called a smart codec. You know, Jason Rode would always talk about this, the CEO on all the conference calls and things like that, and how big this was going to be with the company and whatnot. And so sure enough, an iPhone 6S, that they started using the smart codecs, Apple that is, and Cirrus Logic revenue exploded again, guys. And I took advantage of this, and Cirrus Logic stock went from like a $16, $17 stock to like a $50, $60 stock in a very short amount of time. Unfortunately, I sold out too soon. I sold out like in the 30s and whatnot, and I think maybe my last years I sold out were like 40. So I sold out too soon, unfortunately, but I still made a monster gain on it. And it was a five-figure gain for sure. And it was one of the biggest gains I ever had. And it, once again, it allowed me to trend spot something that no one really understood. I'm like, how does no one understand like how big this iPhone is going to be? How no one understood like how big iPhone 6 is going to be. I'm like, this is the biggest change literally Apple can make with the iPhone. And sure enough, Apple's iPhone sales were up like 30% that next year, and Cirrus Logic's revenue exploded, guys. So that's number two. So what is my greatest investment I've ever made ever? It's a company, ticker symbol CAB. I believe they're still a public company. I heard something they might get bought out or something. Cabela's, all right? Cabela's, what did I see in this company? I saw retail expansion. Basically, up until that time, Cabela's, if you had ever been to one of their stores, they're enormous, enormous. They were like 150,000, 250,000, maybe even 300,000 square feet. Like, unbelievably big. The issue was that with that was it caused such a big footprint that the construction cost to even build a store was so expensive, and also there was tons of wasted space in these stores because it was way too massive, way too expensive, and all the type of things to build. To think about the AC bills in these stores, think about the heating bills, like the cost of running these stores, way too enormous. So Cabela's had an idea to basically start focusing on building stores between 60,000 square feet and 120,000 square feet. I thought this was brilliant. I thought they could integrate it very well as far as still giving the experience of going into Cabela's and still having like a mountain and aquariums and those kinds of things, but not being so ridiculously big that you can't even build any more of these stores because there's such a big waste of money, right? So I saw this trend coming. I knew they could expand this around the country, and sure enough, they started. Then came 2012, which was Obama got reelected. The Sandy Hook massacre happened, right? And, you know, Obama came out. He was very, you know, for gun regulation and whatnot. And people thought this was going to hurt gun sales and whatnot. And I'm like, dude, this is gonna make gun sales explode more than ever. I just think people don't understand like psychology of humans. Like, I think honestly, one of the biggest things you could study in life is psychology of humans. I just think a lot of people just don't understand it. I'm like, this is not gonna, like scare people away from guns. If anything, it's gonna make people go out and buy more guns because they think Obama's gonna take their guns and the NRA would run ads. Obama's trying to take over our guns and this and that. Sure enough, what happened? Gun sales exploded. Gun sales absolutely exploded. I remember going into Cabela's stores, and this is a huge monster store. Like, the gun section of Cabela's is probably 10,000 square feet, maybe 20,000 square feet in itself, just where the ammo and all the pistols are at and whatnot. You couldn't even get to the counter, man. You couldn't even get to the counter because there were so many people there. It was like being in a club just going by the ammo. Ammo sections completely destroyed, like no ammo. If you want ammo, man, you can't even find it anywhere. Completely sold out. And Cabela's stock, you know, after that just exploded like never seen before. They were doing comp store sales of like 20%, which is like beyond ridiculous. Anybody that knows anything about comp store sales, like that's like you can't even picture that in your mind. It's so insane. And Cabela's stock just exploded over the next couple years. And I made by far the most amount of money I ever made. Also, I think I made the biggest percent on my money I ever made because Cabela's was my number one biggest investment. And it was a great retail play that was expanding at that time. And it was just a great play on, you know, what people never saw on the psychology side with what gun sales were going to end up doing. So Cabela's, absolutely my biggest investment ever, my most successful investment ever. Cruise would be number two, and Trinity Industries was huge, not just because I made a good percent of my money, not just because I made money, but because it gave me the confidence that I'm not just going to be an average Joe investor and those kinds of things, guys. So I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed learning about kind of, you know, my story and whatnot, and some of my best investments ever. By the way, make sure you guys check out those links in that description. They should help you out tremendously. Thank you for watching, guys, and have a great day.